Hello, today me, Marina Generalova, will present you the latest economic calendar from InstaForex TV team. Thursday and Friday financial markets movements will be subject to influence of the following statistical releases. To start with, Eurostat is to reveal its final consumer price index figures for December in its report. Most analysts forecast consumer prices to rise 0.3% on a monthly basis and 0.8% year-over-year. Preliminary report revealed inflation in 17 countries of the euro area below the target level of the European Central Bank, thus resuming concern that too weak price growth could undermine the fragile economic recovery in the region. The indicator's preliminary reading rose a modest 0.8%, compared with the same period a year ago, up from 0.1% reading registered in November. In October, the index rose to the tune of 0.7%, thus forcing the ECB to cut its base interest rate to a record low level of 0.25%. Its target level of inflation is just below 2%. Meanwhile, the UK's Office for National Statistics is to report its retail sales, including automotive fuel data for December. The indicator is expected to grow 0.5% on a month-over-month basis and 2.5% annually. Last month, retail sales posted a monthly gain of 0.3%, coming in line with anticipations. On a yearly basis, the indicator climbed 2% against analyst forecast of 2.3%. In addition, in the US, a closely watched consumer sentiment data by the University of Michigan and Thomson Reuters will be unveiled these days. Experts say there are many factors signaling growing confidence in the United States. The preliminary figure is seen to be 83.4 in January. In December, consumer sentiment remained very optimistic. The preliminary reading of 82.5 was confirmed in late December. That was a considerable improvement compared with the final figure of 75.1 in October. Economists surveyed at a high level as well, calling for the score of 82.9. Consumer sentiment growth was seriously affected by the 16-day US government shutdown in early October. However, according to the latest polling data, the situation changed for the better. Thus, lower fuel prices, growing stock prices and strong data from the labor market contributed to improvement. That was all for this week. About the future economic releases, we will tell you on Monday. Goodbye.